With its opening back in September of 2023, the Las Vegas Sphere has set a new benchmark in the entertainment industry. The experience inside is next level, with a screen that spans across the entire ceiling, haptic seats, and a sound system that sends different audio tracks to each individual seat. The Sphere can even generate wind and scents. Sitting here should make you feel like a part of the movie or show that you're watching. And to achieve that, no expense or effort was spared. They literally spent $2.3 billion on creating this next-level cinema experience. But how does all of this actually work? Let's take a look behind the curtain of the Sphere and explore the different technologies that make it happen. For this video, we partnered up with Jared Owen, who built a very detailed model of the Sphere. It's pretty impressive, so please go show some support on his channel as well. The Madison Square Garden Company, or MSG, announced the creation of the Sphere back in 2018. These are the same people behind Radio City Music Hall, the Chicago Theater, and, you guessed it, Madison Square Garden. So they already had experience with building entertainment venues. But with the Sphere, they took things to a whole nother level. They selected the best people from every industry and brought them together to fulfill their vision to reinvent live entertainment. 5 years later, and the Sphere opened for business. And with an exterior like this, it, of course, immediately drew attention. This is the Exosphere, the biggest screen in the entire world. It was designed by Seiko, the company behind some of the world's most amazing light shows and screens. When they came to Vegas, they'd just finished their work on the world's tallest building.
We just finished, at the time, the largest LED screen for a client, Imar, in Dubai, for the Burj Khalifa.
Seiko designed and installed the media facade on the Burj Khalifa, and then immediately set out to break their own record. The Exosphere is 3.5 times bigger than the screen inside, and as we get closer to the screen, it doesn't look like the screen on your television or your phone, but it actually works the same way. That's because screens are made up of pixels. On normal displays, these pixels are simply three tiny lights, known as subpixels. Each is a different color, red, green, and blue. By combining these lights in different intensities, we can produce millions of different colors. And when you put thousands of pixels together and stand back a little, the distinction between the individual pixels becomes blurred. The Exosphere works in the exact same way, except that everything is a lot bigger. It's covered by 1.2 million individual lights, each about the size of a hockey puck. These lights work kind of like the individual pixels on your TV, except that here, each contains a cluster of 48 separate LEDs. As you can see here, each cluster is actually quite far away from each other, so if you're standing closer to the Sphere, it looks like this. But if you're viewing from a distance, as is intended, the lights blend and the image comes together. It's crazy that you could get such a sharp image when you look at it from a distance. If you'd rather watch content and movies on your laptop than in the Sphere, like I do, you've probably had the experience of being geo-blocked at some point in the past. Luckily, there's a solution. And this is where we introduce today's sponsor, CyberGhost VPN. With CyberGhost VPN, all your traffic goes through a secure VPN tunnel. Your IP address is hidden and your data is encrypted. I remember one time I was on a trip to Switzerland with my family and I was all excited to watch the new season of Rick and Morty. So I Googled it, found out that it was on Netflix and watched the first few episodes. But then when I got back to the United States, turns out the rest of the season wasn't on American Netflix, so I had to wait for it to come out on all of the other streaming platforms months later. But thanks to CyberGhost, you can access all kinds of geo-blocked content, YouTube included. Just change your online location, and you can also find better deals online, play games blocked in your region, and even access blocked libraries of over 40 streaming services, like Netflix, Amazon Prime, and Disney Plus. But what's even more important is that CyberGhost VPN protects you against hackers and data brokers that want to sell your information online. CyberGhost's 38 million worldwide users have made it one of the most highly recommended VPNs on Trustpilot. Over 21,000 people have rated it with 4.3 stars. CyberGhost VPN is available for all platforms, Windows, macOS, Android, iOS, and many others. And one subscription can be used on 7 devices, so you can even share with your family and friends. With our link, you get their best deal ever. just $2.03 a month, plus 4 months free, which is 84% off. And there's even a 45-day money-back guarantee, so you've literally got nothing to lose. It's a great product that we at MegaBuilds highly recommend. And by signing up via the link in our description, you can help us continue to create these high-quality videos for all of our viewers just like you. And now let's go inside the Sphere. We first look at the Atrium. This is where a collection of cutting-edge audio and visual technology lies, but what immediately sticks out is the hypervision wall. While the images look three-dimensional, it's actually a clever optical illusion. You remember those little handheld fans with lights on the blades? Well, the holographic wall basically works the same way. Hundreds of little rotors, each with four blades or rays, are attached to the wall. Each one is fitted with LEDs, and they each spin at 670 RPM. So it's comparable to a helicopter, probably even faster than many of those. This makes it way too fast for the human eye to see. And that's why it's possible to display all kinds of sequences. Looks pretty amazing, right? But that's not all. Dotted around the atrium, you can talk to five robots. This is Aura, one of the most advanced humanoid robots in the world.
Hi, my name is Aura. Forget chatbots. Come chat with some real bots.
Designed by an English company called Engineered Arts over the last 15 years, Aura is a combination of advanced robotics and machine learning. They don't walk around, but their upper bodies move as they speak to visitors, answer questions, and give presentations on the technology used at the Sphere. The engineers describe Aura as artificially intelligent, rather than as an artificial intelligence. They built it to run a wide variety of software, including large language models like ChatGPT, voice recognition software like Whisper, and facial recognition technology like Google's MediaPipe. The combination of all of this software makes it possible to interact with Aura. Over time, Aura will learn from visitors and improve their ability to hold conversations. They're already pretty good, and even make some jokes.
Michael, you're supposed to be looking at the camera. You are looking at me. You want to try it one more time? Aw, Michael, are you flirting with me?
Yes. After spending some time with Aura, visitors can move into the theater for the main attraction. This is the Sphere's main screen. It's roughly 20 times larger than the biggest IMAX cinemas and curves over and around the audience. It's made of tiles covered in LEDs that are thin enough to bend to the curve of the Sphere. They're actually so thin that sound can pass through them, but we'll come back to that later. The screen has a whopping 256 million pixels, making it by far the highest resolution screen in the world. At first glance, you could assume that this screen must be super sharp, but that isn't the case, and actually quite the opposite is true. Since the surface is so huge, 160,000 square feet, or over 14,800 square meters to be exact, it only has around 3.33 pixels per inch. For comparison, the latest iPhone has 460 pixels per inch, and a larger TV has around 40 to 80. Despite that, the Sphere screen still looks great. And this is because it's a matter of distance. The optimum viewing distance is the ideal distance between the screen and the audience. The screen in the theater looks crystal clear from the seats, but would start to break up into individual pixels if you got closer to it. And you can actually test this at home. Hold your phone close to a screen, then zoom in as far as you can. If your camera's good enough, you should be able to see each pixel broken down into the red, green, and blue subpixels we talked about back at the beginning of the video. That's because you're now way below the optimum user distance. The designers Seiko had to keep all of this in mind when building the screen. And there was another much more difficult issue they had to tackle as well. Normal cameras that capture film for flat rectangular screens just didn't work for such a big wraparound display. So the filmmakers had to get creative. MSG set up a new company, Sphere Studios, to produce content specifically for the Sphere. They even built a quarter-sized replica in California to edit the films for the Sphere, which they call the Big Dome. On a normal screen, you just couldn't see how it would look in the Sphere. In the beginning, they welded 11 separate cameras together and tried stitching the footage together in post-production. But shooting and editing in that way just turned out to be way too complicated. We certainly couldn't imagine doing it here on MegaBuilds. With no suitable alternative on the market, Sphere Studios decided to build their own. And they ended up making what many consider to be the best video camera ever produced. This is the Big Sky camera system. It's a 316 megapixel camera, shooting 18K film at 120 frames per second. In other words, it films at a super high resolution and everything looks super smooth. The quality is actually so high that 1 second of film takes up to 60 gigabytes of data. And that's not the only inconvenient thing about Big Sky. It actually takes 12 people to operate it. Those 11 cameras from the first model have been replaced by one enormous lens. It measures 1 foot across and bulges out like a fisheye. This gives it a 165-degree field of view, big enough to cover the whole screen in the sphere, and to have some additional room for overshoot and stabilization of the footage. But the lens is only one part of the camera. A sensor is also required to capture the images, and Big Sky's sensor is a record breaker as well. Sphere Studios has partnered with ST Microelectronics to produce the biggest sensor in commercial cinema used anywhere in the world. Here's how it works. The lens bends incoming light rays to converge them onto a focal point. These light rays are then captured by the sensor, which sits behind the lens. The sensor breaks them down into individual pixels and sends electrical signals for each pixel. These signals can then be further processed to produce a digital image. In normal cases, the sensor is a rectangle to correspond to normal TVs, but the sphere is no normal TV. To produce an image that fits onto the sphere's enormous screen, Sphere Studios and ST Microelectronics used an almost squared sensor. This way, it's much better to convert the image. Overall, their new system is so groundbreaking that Sphere Studios have actually filed 10 separate patents for Big Sky's technology alone. And because looking at these images on a normal screen just doesn't really work, the crew uses a VR headset when filming to check and make sure that they've got the right angle. Big Sky is one of the most technologically advanced items in the sphere, but there's something that's equally impressive, the sound system. To match the visuals, the sphere needed something equally impressive in terms of sound. That's why it contains some of the most advanced audio technology, designed by German engineers Holoplot. Hidden behind the sphere's wraparound screen are 167,000 speakers. That works out at 8.4 speakers per person. And remember we talked about the super thin LED screens earlier? Well, they had to make them so thin to allow the sound to pass through without being disrupted. It's called audio transparency, and Holoplot had to work hand in hand with screen designer Seiko in order to even pull it off. What's special about this system is that it can send targeted sound to every seat in the audience, providing custom audio to different parts of the theater. But how is that possible? Take a sound wave, which looks something like this. If you layer another wave on top of it, aligning the peaks, it'll amplify the sound and make it louder. That's called constructive interference. But if you layer two waves like this, aligning the peaks with the troughs, the two waves will cancel each other out. That's called destructive interference. Noise-canceling headphones actually work by using a combination of these interference patterns. Coming out of a speaker, a wave looks like this, with the sound coming out in all directions. But when there's more than one speaker, the different sound waves all mix together and create interference, causing differences in the sound levels across space. Holoplot speakers run extremely complicated calculations to work out where every individual sound wave will interfere with another one. And then they change the moment that the speakers emit certain waves and alter the volume to coordinate every single interference and therefore control which noise reaches which area of the room. The result is kind of like the difference between a light bulb and a laser beam. A light bulb sends out light in all directions, like a traditional speaker, whereas a laser beam sends a focused beam of light. This beam is what Holoplot speakers produce in terms of sound. Using this technology, the sphere can choose the audio track that they send to different parts of the audience, providing different languages, soundtracks, and experiences to different sections of the theater. Sounds complicated, right? Well, it is. It's one of the most advanced sound systems anywhere in the world. They're describing it as headset sound without the headset. If you've enjoyed this video so far, subscribe to MegaBuilds. It helps us out a lot and allows us to both reach more people and continue to put out better and better quality content for each of you. Thank you so much, and we really appreciate your viewership. And in true Sphere style, even the seats add to the experience. 10,000 of the 18,600 seats in the theater are fitted with haptic technology, meaning that the seats can move. During performances, they vibrate at specific frequencies that correspond with what the audience are seeing and hearing. It sounds like a gimmick, but it's said to really add to the experience, kind of like a PlayStation 5 controller. On top of that, wind machines generate anything from gentle breezes to strong gusts, and even smells and fog. Though the team do say that they're careful not to overload the senses of the audience. By this point, you might understandably be wondering how the Sphere is planning on bringing all of these different systems together. Well, for now, they're running two different types of shows. The first is a live show, with artists like U2 and Phish putting on a multimedia performance that honestly looks pretty mind-blowing. The sound system delivers perfect audio to everyone in the audience, and the visuals go from making the Sphere look like a massive concrete silo with a skylight to a wide open desert. Not to mention whatever this thing is. The second is part of the Sphere Immersive Experience. Guests go through the atrium, speaking to all five Aura robots before watching a film called Postcard from Earth in the theater. This film by Darren Aronofsky is the first to be shot on the Big Sky system and tells the story of human development and achievement. Ticket prices range from $79 to over $300, so there are definitely debates about whether it's actually worth the price. Other films are in the works but take a lot of time to produce, and sports events like UFC 306 are also scheduled for the Sphere later in the year. It's not yet clear how that will look, but seeing live combat sports in the full Sphere immersion sounds honestly pretty crazy. Looking to the future, other Spheres are in the pipeline as well. Until recently, the most likely seemed to be in London, and MSG has even bought the land to build it on. However, concern from local residents about light pollution caused the mayor of London to reject the proposal, and MSG ultimately decided to abandon the project. Abu Dhabi, South Korea, and Saudi Arabia have all expressed interest in their own sphere, and though MSG has held talks with all of them, for now, nothing is for sure. In the near future, Sphere Studios plan to take Big Sky to the International Space Station. They want to film a spacewalk in real dimensions and transport viewers beyond the atmosphere. Would you like to visit the Sphere someday? And if you've already been, would you say it's worth it? Let us know your thoughts in the comments down below. And if you want to try our sponsor, CyberGhost VPN, make sure to use our link down below in the description. This application will protect your data while you browse and give you full access to all blocked content on the internet. This supports us as well. It's a great VPN, just like their current deal for $2.03 a month and 45 days money back guaranteed. So it's totally risk free. That's it for today. So thanks a lot for watching. And as always, we'll see you in the next video.